Okay, guys, so I've never really used this part of my camera. It basically saves my front camera and my back camera all together, which is why I originally bought this phone. So, doing my morning routine, it is in the afternoon because I'm a lazy farmer. So I don't do anything in the morning. Normally what I do is I come out here, my dogs are gonna go to the bathroom and poop all over my yard. It's starting to sprinkle, but, you know, whatever. I come out here, I check my pigeon loft. I have 3 pigeons out of the original 7 that I have. 2 got strung on the wing and took off after the first week of free flight. And then I lost 2 other ones to bird of prey attacks, so hawks and stuff like that. So we still have 73, I believe, or 74. This little guy here that I have yet to name, and then Seabiscuit. So I didn't name them because I don't know what sex they are. I'm assuming she is a female and that's a boy, but I'm not 100% sure. So I don't know what to name them. I am going off of, you know, racehorse names. So right now they're just, you know, whatever. So I'm going to go ahead and open this up for them today. They are not flying today. I let them out yesterday. I need to clean this. It's gross. That's like 2 days worth of poop for them because they like to sit here and just, well, sit there. I am getting 8 more today. So I will put that on video once I get them. They should be arriving any time right now. And I did try to fix my loft so it doesn't drip. But it's dripping and I get water puddles. It's not as bad. So what my idea was, I'm going to go ahead and grab a tarp and put a tarp over the whole thing. I mean, this was kind of like a hodgepodge put together loft. The pigeons don't care, honestly. I care because I don't want them getting overly cold in the winter. So I am going to put a tarp over it. I have a tarp that I used. I made a shelter for the horses. It was like one of those garages in a box thing. But we had a wicked windstorm blow through. And it like literally broke the piping to that shelter. So now I'm like, okay, well, now I can't even remember that. So now my next thing I do is come over here to the small chicken coop. And let these little suckers out. Hi, guys. These are all New Jersey Giant babies. They are about... Oh, I don't know. I don't even know. I'm guessing they are approximately 2 months old, would be my guess. What are you doing out? So we have 1 loose duck. You're not supposed to be out here. So... apparently my daughter didn't close them in properly last night. What are you doing? Come on, let's go get your friends. Oh, she didn't close it right at all. We got ducks everywhere. Poop, gross. Yeah, I'm gonna have to talk to my child. Her responsibility is get the ducks in.
Hi, Sassy. Hi, Fancy.
Get the ducks in overnight and then... make sure they're safe. Well, they're not safe, but they're not in their pen, basically. And then I come over here and I grab scoopsies of food for them. Yummy, yummy food. Big birds get 3 scoops. Oh, I know. Let me open the thing. This is kind of like my morning craziness. And... it's just what I do. Live on a bird farm, have birds. So much fun, I say. Come on. Everyone out. Let's go. Outside. Go, go, go. Go. Go, you guys know where you're going. Oh, we're being difficult today. So, I'll just walk and they'll follow. Come on. There we go. We know where we're going. That's Achilles. Nala, leave them alone. So I got three boys, two girls, three girls. And they eat like they've never eaten before. Yes, gotta love the birds. Okay. So, look at that. It's getting dark. And I got my sheep who are outside because if I don't lock them up, they get into everything. Let me close this over here because my dogs will steal the duck eggs. And it looks like one's already gone. And then she gets diarrhea. Hold on, ponies. I'll let you guys out in a minute. Then I let all my New York Giants out. Look at all my birds. So I let all them out. Hi, guys. And they're just as bad as everyone else. Where did I put my bucket? Nala! Chickens everywhere! Now, New York Giants are pretty hardy birds. I did go with the bromas and stuff after a while, but I figured it's just easier to get birds that are honestly very hardy for the winter. That loud guy there is Sheriff. He's one of the original ones. We did lose my Fischer'd. He has a couple of babies in this flock. The really, really black ones are from him. Come on, guys. And it's kind of one of those trade-offs. Excuse you. Get out of the bucket. My goodness. Everyone gets fed at a certain time, which just makes life a little easier for me. Go. Eat my birds. Eat. These are just for eggs. We don't eat our birds. These are just our layers. This is where they lay their eggs. But being it's not laying season, I haven't checked. It's probably just gross and full of poop because now they lay in it just asleep. Yeah, as I said, I need to clean that too. So, birds get cleaned once a week. And horses get cleaned daily. So, they get kind of nasty, but once a week is as much as I really need to do them, just because they are outside 24/7 almost. They come out, and then they get stuck inside, and my sheep like to come out and eat all my grass hay, so I kind of shush them away, tell them to stay over there, or I'll eat you. Coconut has turned into a little brat. So this is me just shushing them away. My horses have water out here. And the chump field pasture is open. So they can go out there and run around and do their thing. So then I come over here. And Dennis one hand is kind of funny. And I tie this string up right here to my garage. Because this keeps my horses, funny enough, I'm going to my neighbor's. Have you ever tried tying something with one hand? It's actually extremely difficult. Okay. It's not tight, but it's there. Got the point. Okay, and then we let Sassy out. Hi, Sassy. It's you, my old girl. Can you guys believe that this old fart here is 19 years old? 19, yeah. I've had her since 2002, and nope, she was born in 2002. I've had her since 2004, I believe, or 2003. I got her when she was, 2003. She was barely 2 years old. Go, my old fart! You're a sexy beastness. Go outside! And then we let little Miss Fancy out. Yeah, she's my bad pony. If I can get her unlatched. So with Fancy, we do a whole weight thing. Back up. Back. Back. You wait. That way she's not just running around. Which is funny because anywhere else in the world, back. She would be mad at me. Okay, outside. My sexy beast of a spotted butt. Go on. She beast, you know better. Get. See, this is why I yell at him. Come on, let's go. Go. Shh. 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 Go, fancy. And my sheep know better. Let's go. Come on. Go. This is the... You're so dumb. Go on. Okay, so now that the sheep are in there, look, the sun's finally coming out. It's like the sun needed to see the beauty of my horses, and that's all the gross mud that I have. And my arena that's somehow managing to hold on. Okay, so this is the tarp. This is the tarp I'm going to use to put over my my loft. That was part of the shelter. Here are pieces of my shelter. These are the only pieces that were actually not broken, so that's good. But the rest of it broke, so this is why I have the horses back inside the stalls. So after the horses are out, what I do is I come back in here and I check to see how much hay they ate overnight. Because I like them to be eating all the time they're in here. So I can kind of look and say, okay, Fancy's a little bit hungrier. So I might give her one more flake tonight. And then we go in the Sassy stall and she has the right amount of food for her. And so then I'll clean later. So Fancy does have water. It's just on the outside of her thing. She has to reach her neck over and drink because we stick it inside her stall and she dumps it. So this is actually where she drinks her water to keep the water in the bucket because she will dump it and then we have a flooded stall and that's just gross. So the hay that I ended up getting yesterday, this is my winter water well because our water hoses freeze and I hate frozen water. So we have the big black one up there for them outside. We have this one for inside. And then it's kind of dusty, but we free-filled it yesterday. This is so that I can bucket water into the stalls when the water hose is frozen because we don't have inside water. So this is the hay that I got yesterday. It's so pretty. Like, this is good hay. Compared to the crap that I had, this is good hay. So... Ooh, it smells nice too. This is the hay I got. Look how nice and green this is. This is absolutely gorgeous hay. First cut Timothy hay from this year. And then this is the hay that I got. This is the round bell, leftover round bell. And like I was saying, it's full of weeds. Like, if this was truly from a hay field, you wouldn't find these types of weeds. Now, granted, my horses will eat it, so this is kind of like I'm still gonna feed them this on top of this. But it's just so, I don't know. Guys, it's like, look, it's vining, and I'm more concerned about the horses getting stuck with vines in their throat. Like, what even is this? This is not even grass. This is like, I don't know. I found like a, I don't know what it's called. Like the thorn things from like raspberry bush. Like this one right here. Look at this. Look. You see those thorns? Like, that's not from a hay field. You can't tell me that's from a grass field. Look at those thorns. Like, that's stuff that shouldn't even be in the hay. This is what they sold me for $65. I thought, honestly, that it was horse hay until I opened it up and then I was like, that's not horse hay. So yeah, that's what I got. So that is why I ended up buying the hay that I bought yesterday, because I can't feed my horses something that could potentially harm them. Not that my horses are picky, they'll eat anything I stick in front of their noses, but it was more for my benefit to know that my horses are getting something that's healthy for them. I need to put the back one on. Apparently the wind decided that blowing it out would be a good thing, so it's not hooked up. So I'm gonna have to come back here and refedangle that later. So, okay, so that's what I did. That is pretty much my update. Now I'm just waiting for my pigeons, wherever they are. They were supposed to arrive today. They're on delivery. Clean my thing. But apparently, I don't know, they're late. Like, I'm home. I told them, I was like, I'll be home all day. Make sure they deliver them here so that I don't have to drive 20 minutes out of my way to the post office, because they like to take them so far. Now let's stay. My post office. Okay, so there's one down the street. It's literally stay 5 minutes from my house. Okay, that's the Madison post office, which I thought was mine. My post office is actually Farmington, which is 20 minutes away. The other side. Like, how come I'm not in the Macedon district? It's literally 2 car turns down this road, and am I at the post office? No, I have to drive clear across town, because they make no sense. Okay, so no mail yet. So mailman has not come yet, so that's good. Thanks, Dirty. So guys, I am going to let you guys go, because I don't want this video getting too long, because it takes forever to get on thing. So I will make another video maybe tomorrow of the new pigeons, because I'll probably just let them settle in today, and we will go from there. Okay guys, as always, helmets on, heels down, be safe out there, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye.